In my last video, I shared with you the differences and the similarities between the C corporation and the LLC. Now in that video, I mentioned that the C corporation, which is just the normal regular corporation, is taxed differently than the LLC. So in this video, I'd like to share with you how they're taxed differently, and also I will introduce the concept of the S corporation, which is a special tax treatment that you can elect once you have registered your legal entity. So stay tuned. All of this will become very clear to you after you watch this video. Hi everyone, Victor from True North Business Partners here. On this channel, we discuss and talk about everything entrepreneurship. We share with you strategies, information, and tips that you can use to start and grow your own business. So if you have not subscribed yet, please click on the subscribe button below and don't forget the notification bell. Click on it so that you will always get the updates from us when we have new videos coming out. Now, because of the content and the subject matter we're discussing today, I will need to show you a disclaimer again. So please bear with me for a few seconds. I'll come right back. In my last video, I shared with you what is a C corporation and what is an LLC, and what are the similarities and the differences between the two. I also mentioned and laid out some criteria that you can use to choose the best legal entity for your business. So if you did not watch that video, here's the link to that video. You might want to start there. I also put the link on the bottom in the description so you can find it easily. Start there, watch that video first, and then come back and watch this one. Now let me turn the video to my laptop screen so I can share with you how the LLC and the C-Corp are taxed differently, and also introduce to you the concept of the S-Corporation, which you might want to consider. Okay, so let's take a look at the LLC, the C-Corp, and the S-Corp, and how they are taxed. Well, first, let's do a quick recap. The LLC and the C-Corps are their own legal entities. And by incorporating, becoming a C-Corp and an LLC, it will protect you personally from business liabilities. Basically, these legal entities shield your personal assets. So if you're sued, or there's any other type of damages that people can seek from you, because of your business operations, the LLC and the C-Corp will shield your personal assets, your personal properties like your house, your personal bank accounts, your personal investments from and away from these damages. So they are shielded from those lawsuits. Now we talked about the LLC and the C-Corp are different in four main ways. One, the way that they're owned, the ownership is different. The way they're managed is different. The reporting requirements are different. I talk about how they're different in the companion video. So if you didn't watch that, please go watch that one. And then here, we're going to talk about how the LLC and the C-Corp are taxed differently. And also, I will introduce to you again the S-Corp, which is a tax treatment election that you can elect if you are a C-Corporation. So first, the C Corporation. Now, the C Corporation is its own separate legal entity. So by definition and by law, the C Corporation pays its own corporate income tax. So what that means is if you operate your business under a C Corporation and you incorporate under a C Corporation, at the end of your business year or fiscal year, you tally up all of your income, your losses, your everything, your deduction. So the corporation itself pays its own taxes. Now, as the shareholder of the C corporation, if you're an owner of the C corporation, you're the shareholder, you also pay taxes on the dividends that you receive from your business, from your C corporation. So you put the dividends as income in your personal income tax, and you pay tax on that. So what does that mean? That means you are basically being double taxed. You're paying one tax at the corporate level and paying another tax at the personal level. Corporate income tax and personal income tax. So that's how the C corporation is taxed for you as a shareholder. Now let's talk about the S corporation. As I mentioned to you before, the S corp is a tax treatment election that you can make. So what that means, however, is that you must form a C corporation first. Once your C corp is formed, you must make the election to be treated as an S corp as far as the taxes goes. Now, how do you make that election? Well, you make that election by filling out Form 2553 and submit it to the IRS. There's a deadline for that submission, and that is you must submit it before the 15th day of the third month of your first tax year. So if you are a recently incorporated business, you've just incorporated, that means you have to make your S-Corp selection before the 15th day of the third month, right after your incorporation. Now, once you're approved as an S-Corp, that means your business, the S-Corp, is now a pass-through entity. What does that mean? That means all of the income, the credits, the deduction, the losses of the business flow to the shareholders, the individual shareholders. The business, the corporation, no longer file a corporate income tax. The shareholders individually, based on the income that's flow and passed through to them, file their own individual income taxes. So let me just recap. If you are an S-Corp, you do not file a corporate income tax. The income, the credits, deduction, and the losses all flow down to, pass through to the individual shareholders. The individual shareholders will then take those income and losses, whatever they may be, and file individual income taxes. Now, what we've been talking about is how the federal government will treat an S-Corp. The states and the state taxes differ from state to state. Most states will treat the S-Corp just like the federal government will, and it's a flow through, it's a pass through. However, there are some states like California that still require an S-Corp to pay state taxes, or in California, it's called franchise taxes. So make sure you check with your state's Secretary of State to know and figure out how your state treats an S-Corp. Now, because the election of the S-Corp allows you to avoid double taxation, there are also certain requirements that you must meet before you can make that S-Corp election. So first, your corporation must be a domestic corporation. What that means is your business must have been incorporated in one of the 50 states here in the United States of America. It cannot be a foreign corporation. And then second, your corporation must not have more than 100 shareholders. So for most businesses, startups, this is probably not a big issue. However, you do want to think about the future. If you are thinking about getting investors to invest into your company and a large amount of investors, you might want to think about making the election to S Corp, because it caps you at 100 shareholders. Now, there are also requirements as to what type of person can be a shareholder in an S-Corp. Well, first of all, natural persons, individuals, and then there are certain trusts and estates that can also be shareholders of an S-Corp. Another corporation, partnerships, cannot be shareholders of an S-Corporation. Also, non-resident aliens, people who are not U.S. citizens, cannot be shareholders of an S-Corp. Next requirement is that the S-Corp can only have one class of stock. Whereas a C-Corp, you can have multiple classes of different types of stocks. S-Corp, you can only have one class. Lastly, as an S-Corp, you cannot operate as an insurance company. You cannot operate as certain types of financial institutions. Also, you cannot operate as an international sales corporation selling stuff, things, products to other nations outside of the U.S. Okay, now let's take a look at how the LLC is taxed. As we have mentioned before, the LLC is its own separate legal entity. However, under the tax law of the United States, the LLC is not a separate tax entity. So the LLC does not pay its own corporate taxes. It is treated as a pass-through entity, just like the S-Corp. So I hope you remember what that means is that the income, the credits, deduction, the losses of the business of the LLC all flow down to the individual member level. As a member of a LLC, you will file individual income tax returns and not an LLC level corporate tax return. If you are a one member LLC, you're taxed as a sole proprietor. The IRS calls this entity a disregarded entity. But don't worry about why you're called that. It's just a name that the IRS came up with. As a one-member LLC, the member will be taxed as a sole proprietor. You file a Schedule C with your individual income tax return. If there are two or more members to the LLC, the LLC is taxed as a partnership. So what that means is, again, there's still no LLC corporate level tax returns. The individual members will get a K-1 form from the LLC, and each individual member will file his or her individual income tax returns. Hopefully you're asking the question now, well then how do I choose? Which business entity or legal entity do I choose for my business? Well, here are some criteria for you to make that decision. Let's go over them. A protection of personal assets. All three of the legal entities do that. So the LLC, the C-Corp, and S-Corp will help you to protect your personal assets, your own home, your personal bank accounts, your personal investments. LLC, the C-Corp, and S-Corp will help you to protect from business laws, from lawsuits, and things like that. Of course, there are exceptions to that, but as long as you don't do anything crazy, you should be fine with either of these three entities with regards to personal asset protection. Now, if you're a single owner, it's probably best for you to consider the LLC. It's easier for you to manage, it's easier for you to know what's going on, and you also don't have to go through lots of the legal requirements as far as managing and having meetings, board meetings, shareholder meetings, and things like that. Now, if you have a small group of owners that you work with, business partners that you work with, and you guys work well together, and it's only going to be this small group of people that will manage the company, the business, then you might want to consider, again, the LLC and possibly the S-Corp as well. The S-Corp and the LLC, because the way that they are built, the way they are created, really does foster relationships and business relationships and business development among a small group of owners. Now, with regard to ease of management, if you're really looking for a business that's just easy to manage, a business entity that's easy to manage, you probably want to go with an LLC. It is easy to manage, just the way that it's created. It is for ease of management. The C-Corp has, you know, bylaws where you have to get together, shareholder meetings, board meetings, and other things that are required as far as managing the company goes. And remember, the S-Corp is really a C-Corp, just a different tax treatment. So the S-Corp has to go through all of those formalities as well. Now, if you're looking to avoid double taxation, look at the pass-through entities, right? The LLC and the S-Corp. Now, if you're looking for outside investment and you're seeking many investors to come in and invest into your company, so eventually you're expecting a larger group of investors, of people who are going to be shareholders, and then you're also looking for structure in managing your business because of the larger amount of people that are involved, shareholders. You have a board member that can take a look at your business and be responsible for the operation of the business. Then you want to look at both the C-Corp and the S-Corp. Again, remember, the S-Corp is just a C-Corp with a different way of taxation. If those three things, the larger group of people that are owning, that are shareholders, and you're looking for a large number of investors, and you're looking for good corporate structure to operate, accountability for your business, then you want to look at the C-Corp and or the S-Corp. So hopefully this chart will give you some guidance as to what your business is like, and then based on that, how to choose the right legal entity for your business. Well, I hope this video has provided you some very valuable information and practical ways that you can choose the right legal entity for your business. Please make sure you watch the companion video. I did make another video to tell you about the differences and the similarities of C-Corp, S-Corp, and LLC. So you should make that decision on which legal entity to choose based on the information from both of these videos. Please make sure you take a look. Well, thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We'd love to hear from you. If you have any questions, thoughts, comments, please let us know. You can go to our website, www.truenorthbp.com. Leave us comments there or check out any one of our social media outlets, YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. Just look for at True North Business Partners. Or you can just drop us an email at hello@truenorthbp.com. We'd love to hear from you. Tell us what else you want to learn and what else you want to hear, and we will provide those information to you. Again, thank you so much. Take care.